My name is John Hoggins, and I'm the Secretary and Treasurer of both Our Lady of the Grove Knots and of Dignity Baltimore, and tonight I'm a minister in Windsor Canton. Welcome to the celebration of the liturgy with Our Lady of the Grove Knots Faith Community. Today is the Feast of the Ascension, or the seventh Sunday in Easter. Our Lady of the Grove Knots, or OLUK, is an inclusive Catholic faith community, open to all who walk our way with respect. We are also the Baltimore chapter of Dignity USA, which is dedicated to sacramental and social justice for the LGBTQ+ community and our families and friends. Our vision is to rebuild Christ's Church by seeking out and providing an accepting, accommodating, and aspirational spiritual home for disenchanted, disengaged, and disaffected Catholics and others in the Baltimore metro area. Now let us take a moment to pause, be silent, and place ourselves in the presence of God as we prepare for the liturgy to begin. Our celebrants this evening as Father Stahley, Con-celebrating as our pastor, Father Risdorfer. Please stand and join our opening hymn, number 770, Green Gathered Book, number 770, Soon and Very Soon.
Amen. First reading is a reading from the beginning of the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up. After giving instructions, though, the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, he presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days he will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom of Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garb stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus who had taken up from you into heaven will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe, in accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead, and seating him at the right hand of the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet, and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is the body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Especially so with mysteries that have to do with our faith. with the religion that we have inherited with our very spiritual existence. And the lesson that I learned is that I can apply my education, my reasoning, my experiences to these mysteries, and I just don't do any better. I am still at that wall, banging my head. And the realization finally came years ago that if I really want to go deeper and get a grasp on these things, invariably I have to turn to the poets, to the musicians, to the artists. And that's where I'll find the answers. That's where I'll be able to begin to make some level of sense about what's going on. And the reason I share that with you is because of the feast that we celebrate, the Feast of the Ascension. Something that through my young life and through my college years and my years in the seminary, I would puzzle with and try to figure out what is the essence of this mystery? What does it mean? How can I come to terms with it? How can I understand it? And true enough, it wasn't until I was in the presence of a great, great artist who laid this out in what I had never thought of before, that the pieces began to come together and some sense emerged. And the artist to whom I refer is a filmmaker. You may be familiar with him. His name is Franco Zeffirelli. He has made many very famous films. But the film to which I'm referring here is Jesus of Nazareth. It came on TV as a miniseries back in the mid or late 70s. And I cannot tell you how many times I have revisited that over the years. I was fortunate in that my first viewing of it came when I was getting close to my ordination to the priesthood, struggling with all of the great theologians, Augustine, Thomas Aquinas, St. Bonaventure, Karl Rahner, getting ready to take my comprehensive exam to Catholic University, stuffing my head full of all that theology, trying to remember all the philosophy I had learned. And here comes this work of art, Jesus of Nazareth, a film put together by Franco Zeffirelli. And I will, until my dying day, believe that he was inspired when he made that film, and the way that he pulled the pieces together from the gospel versions of the life of Jesus. And what I just want to share with you very briefly is the final scene of that movie, where for the first time in my life, I began to understand what the mystery of the Ascension meant, and how it worked in the lives not just of the apostles, but how it was actively working in my own life. And the final scene of that movie, if you'll let me paint the picture, it portrays the risen Christ, and he's in the upper room with his apostles. Now this is after his death. This is the resurrected Jesus who is in this room where the apostles are literally hiding out. They've been overwhelmed with joy to see their risen Savior. But in this particular scene, at the end of the movie, Jesus has just broken the news to them that he's leaving. He's going to be returning, as he says, to the Father. He's going back. So the apostles are in a state of utter confusion. They're fearful. They're troubled. They don't know what's coming next. Here they've gone through the passion and the brutal execution of their leader. They've seen him in his transformed state after the resurrection. They think that the restoration of Israel, the coming kingdom of justice and peace, is just around the corner. And here in this scene, Jesus tells them that he must go away. He must go away. And it's a very, very tender scene, because all those violent emotions are right on the surface. And Jesus is sitting with them, and he has his arm outstretched, and Peter is leaning in close to him. Peter's head is right like that. And on the other arm, he's got John. And you can tell that they are utterly confused. And it's the final words that he says to them that I want to share with them, with you. Because Peter has just said, Lord, Lord, please don't leave us. The day is slipping away. And the night is coming. Of course, what he means is something much greater than the night, but the darkness of being lost and confused again. And Jesus speaks to them, and the camera is only a great promise to do. The camera puts him on the face of Jesus, and he says to them, don't be afraid. I am with you always, even to the end of time. Don't be afraid. I am with you always, even to the end of time. And then the movie ends. And I wanted to share that with you because of the effect that it had on me, which was all of my struggle with the mechanics, if you will, of the ascension. Where were they standing? Who was there? How did he go up? How far did he go up? What did this one say? Who stepped out of there? Forget it. Here is the essence. Here is the essence. Do not be afraid. I am with you until the end of time. And when I saw that presentation at the hands of that fantastic artist, the meaning came right into my heart like a tornado. And I understood. I understood. That's what it means. The other logistics, if you will, of how high do you go, where did you go, you know, maybe I'll figure it out someday. I heard a commentary about one theologian who was mentioning the ascension. And I forget who it was, but the theologian said, you know, if you're locked into that frame of mind and you're wondering about Jesus ascending, the theologian said, even if Jesus was leaving at the speed of light, he still went out of the solar system. So, I mean, you know, I'll leave all the logistics to someone else. But it was that scene. And the message is, don't be afraid. And my brothers and sisters, when I revisited that scene, not only does it teach me the meaning of the ascension, it puts me back in touch with the promise that Jesus made to send the Holy Spirit. And I can just feel the presence of the Spirit. And I know that regardless of what's happening, regardless of how crazy things are around me, regardless of all the things that I and all of us have to be worried about, to fear, don't be afraid, because I am with you until the end of time. Amen. Word of our faith, the words of the creed, the belief.
God, the Father of Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God of God, light from the light, true God of true God, begotten.
For all those who are struggling with mental health issues.
Father, we ask that you hear our petitions that we bring to you today. Hear the passion, show your mercy to the world who need your help. We ask this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn this evening is number 695 in your green guidebooks, number 695, Only This I Love.
Thank you.
for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, a death he freely accepted, he took bread, gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." And let us now proclaim the mystery of faith. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you. All the same word, I shall be given.
Thank you.
out to Father Al, me, or Chip, we can get you in touch with what we're doing and how you can be involved.
We particularly need people to set up and take care. So on Sunday, for example, when we're back here in my Mass, we take down there at 4 o'clock. Yeah, so it's pretty much the one we have on there. Third thing is to remind you, Father Al's guided tour of Holy Moon takes place March 12th to the 21st. I'll go short shortly, but the website will answer. It's a bargain, not to mention you get my exquisite commentary for all the places to do this. Tony and I are going to see that trip in 5 days in Egypt. I have got to see pyramids before. So we're going to do that. And if you're interested in that, it's just a little more money, but the let us know, because I have a person over there, a wonderful lady that Chip introduced to, she's working with the SMS. She's essentially our tour guide, not tour guide, she's putting everything together. It's going to be a couple days in Cairo, one which in Giza, then we're going to fly down to Aswan, we're going to get on the Mount of Hermes, we're going to visit Luxor, Abu Sabel, Luxor, and then Cairo, another day in Egypt, and we'll fly to Cairo. So hopefully somebody will join us and spread the word. If you get a hundred shows on that person. Anything else?
Let us pray. Father, in this Eucharist, we touch the divine life you give to the world. Help us to follow Christ with love, to eternal life, where he is Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. As is our tradition, we'll sing a hymn to Our Lady. Tonight that hymn will be number 447, Regina Chaley.
Thank you.
not let the chaos, brutality, and evil of war reign in Ukraine, but only a forever peace that comes from you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our closing hymn this evening is number 675.